Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create an Angular application and configure the Syncfusion Angular Query Builder component in it. Using the Angular Query Builder, you can filter large amounts of data by creating or editing conditions that can be combined with data visualization controls like DataGrid and charts to view the filtered data. Let's start with the application creation process. First, I initialize my app using the Angular CLI. I will use VS Code as the editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. In VS Code, I install the CLI tool globally using the command npm install global Angular CLI. Then, I create a new Angular project using the ng new command and provide the app name, my Angular project. I am asked if I want to add Angular routing and I enter no. Then I choose CSS as the stylesheet format. I navigate to the location where my new project has been created. To start using the Query Builder component, I install the Query Builder package using the command ng add Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Query Builder. Before going any further, I need to register the Syncfusion trial license key. I open the main.ts file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the Angular trial license key. Since the 2022 Volume 1 release, the trial license key is mandatory for Angular products to avoid a licensing warning. For info on how to generate a trial license key, check the video description below. Next, I navigate to the App Module page where the Query Builder module has been imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Query Builder package and registered in the Imports array of the ng module. In the style.css file, the material theme CSS style is imported for Angular products. In the App Component HTML file, I replace the default code snippets with an EJS Query Builder tag. Next, I need to define the columns to display in the Query Builder. You can create or delete a condition or group based on columns. I add the eColumns tag to define the columns collection. Then I include the eColumn tag to define a single column. After that, I include the field property and assign the employee ID field. Then I add a label and set its type as number. In the same way, I add the other columns with appropriate types. I am going to provide the value, such as Mr. or Mrs., for this Boolean field. Here, I declare a variable named values of type string and define the titles. Assign this variable to the values property. Let me run this project using the command ng serve. See, a basic query builder is rendered. It allows you to create conditions and group them using and/or logic. Notice the columns are shown in the dropdown and you can add conditions based on them. Let me show you how to set rules on the component's initial rendering. I define the variable rules of type object and specify the condition as or, the rules as label to title, Field to title. Type to string. Operator to ends with. And value to representative. Assign this object to the rules property of Query Builder. Check the component now. The specified rule is applied to the Query Builder on initial loading. Next, I will show you how to integrate Query Builder with the grid component. In this example, I am going to filter the grid records using the Query Builder. First, to render the grid component, I install the grid package using the command ng-add Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Grids. Notice here in the app module page, the grid module and pager module are imported and injected into the imports array of the ng module. As I said earlier, I am going to define the Angular DataGrid component. So, I add the existing Angular DataGrid code snippet here. The explanation for this code snippet is given clearly in the Angular DataGrid documentation page, which you can find in the description below. Also, check out the video link shown in the card above to learn more about the Angular DataGrid component. To filter the grid records on changing the rules, I use the rule change event of the Query Builder. I assign the callback method, updateRule. I define this method here, and it receives arguments of type rule change event args. Notice that rule change event args is imported from Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Query Builder. Here I'm going to process the rules as data manager query. So, I import the data manager, query, predicate, and return option from the Syncfusion EJ2 data package. To get the query builder rule, I add the reference variable to the query builder. I import the view child from Angular core, and then I create the query builder instance. To filter the records based on the rules, I declare a variable predicate and get the rules by calling the getPredicate method using Query Builder instance. I declare another empty variable, filterDataSource, and a variable for dataManagerQuery. I add an if condition to check whether the predicate is undefined or null, and then construct the query to update all the records. Otherwise, I will construct the query to upload the records based on the predicate. I initialize the data manager with the DataSource employee data and execute the query we have just created. Now the rule is checked for all the objects in the DataSource, and the data that matches the rule is pushed into the filtered DataSource variable. And, to update this generated data source to the grid, I add the reference variable to the grid component. And assign the grid component instance using the view child. At last, refresh the grid component using the refresh method. Notice here, I have applied the rules on initial loading. When the application is refreshed, the grid data source will not be updated based on the rule applied. But when I change the rule, the records will be updated. To address this, I add the created event in the grid component and assign the callback method onGridCreated. I will define this method in the app component TS file. Inside this method, I call the updateRule method and pass the rule to the getValidRules method using the QueryBuilder object. As its name indicates, it converts the rule into a valid one. Based on this logic here, the grid records will be filtered based on the rules. Check now, the grid records are filtered based on rule applied on the query builder's initial rendering. In this video, you have seen how to configure the Syncfusion Angular Query Builder component using the Angular CLI tool and the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Query Builder package. I also showed you how to configure a few of the control's basic features. You can download the working example used in this video from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also included a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.